I have every confidence that your deliberations in Islamabad will be fruitful and allow you to deal with a whole range of important issues on the ministerial agenda. Ladies and gentlemen, in conceiving SAARC 3 decades ago, we vowed to bring peace, freedom, social justice, and economic prosperity for the peoples of our region. Those commitments constitute the very basis of the SAARC Charter, and the realization of these commitments is our collective responsibility. In this age of globalization and ever-increasing connectivity, our challenges are common and fears and concerns shared. This interdependence calls for ever greater regional cohesion in implementing joint strategies. The order indeed is tall with a range of issues on your agenda, including terrorism, narcotics, piracy, cyber crimes, corruption, and trafficking in women and children. At national level, the remarkable gains made against the terrorists through Operation Zarb-e-Azm and the effective implementation of the National Action Plan reflect our government's determination to eliminate the scourge of terrorism from our soil for good. Excellencies, despite numerous challenges, SAARC has made commendable contributions in promoting greater regional integration in South Asia to make SAARC a more effective and viable regional organization responsive to the aspirations of people. All of us, the national governments, the SAARC Secretariat, and its regional centers and specialized bodies need to make sustained and concerted efforts.